Good morning, everyone. This is Vishwanath Sandilya, international rated player in chess. First of all, thank you very much for subscribing for my YouTube channel and have many likes in Facebook. So today in this video, I'm going to show how the online coaching works for the advanced students. So in this video, I'm going to analyze a game which is played by Anatoly Karpov versus Luthier Joel in the year 1992. It's a Bale tournament. Okay, so here Karpov is white and Luthier Joel is black. So d4. So one of the standard opening Karpov used to play for, as his main weapon, d5, c4, c6, knight c3, knight f6. So this is a Slav defense. E3, E6. So there are many variations in this opening. You can watch my videos, previous videos in the Slav defense. For example, in this position, what happens if you play something like Bishop F5 before E6? So these videos you can find in my previous channel, previous videos. After Bishop F5, Cd5, how black is going to lose the game after Queen B3. So E6, Knight F3, Knight Bd7, Queen C2. So this Queen C2 is mainly played just to wait for one move. Like in this move, I can play like Bishop D3 to do castling. But I waited Queen C2 so that if black captures D into C4, I can gain a tempo by moving Bishop into C4. And Queen C2 is also having some other useful ideas where will you can find during the later stages of the game. Okay, so Bishop D6, Bishop E2, castle and castle. Okay, so Rook E8. So in the advanced class, now I'm going to start analyze from this move, as till 8 moves are very very most popular, like everyone used to know this setup and everyone knows what is the idea behind this. And after this, I'm going to tell you one thing. After this game, the entire theory of this opening has been changed, and I'm going to show you after the game. So Rook E8, so the idea is pretty clear. I want to maybe I want to capture this and play something like E5. Okay, so the main reason of threatening to play E5 is to open the bishop on C8. So this is the main idea. Okay, now playing from white side, you need to stop that. So I'm giving some suggestions for the intermediate or little advanced level. Whenever you are trying to stop your opponent ideas or opponent plan, just make sure you try to do with the pieces. And if you fail to do with the pieces, then you try to move some pawns to stop that. Okay, so this E5 is little trouble now. So I hope you can just pause the game and find out a good move in this position if you like to. Okay, so the move is Rook D1. It's a very nice move. One of the main ideas of playing Queen C2 is to vacate the D1 square for the rook, and you get one more idea after few moves later. So Rook D1, directly creating an X-ray attack on the queen. Now black cannot play E5 as he is losing the pawn on D5. D into E5, knight into E5, C into D5, C into D5, knight into D5, knight into D5, rook into D5. So white is gaining a pawn here. As we can see, there is no tactical threats of capturing this and queen into, because this there is a bishop in between and there is a knight here. So if he tries to capture knight into knight, and luckily bishop into f3, this bishop is only guarding the rook on d5, so that there won't be any tactical chance of bishop h2 and queen into d5. So if you don't understand, I'll just explain. e5, let us say e5, d5, knight e5, cd5, cd5, nd5, nd5, rook into d5. So if you want, just move this one and take this pawn with a check, and followed by queen into rook. This bishop is only supporting the d5. So white is a healthy pawn up, and I think it's clearly better for white. So let us go back. So for rook d1, black played queen e7, which is very logical to move away the queen from the line of attack. So after queen e7, now he is threatening the same thing again, so maybe like d into e4, followed by e5. Okay, so the now just hold, just pause the game for another few moments and try to find a best move from the white side. Okay, so I hope you find that. So here, now you can get the idea of queen c2 one more time. The idea is e5, okay, after capture, capture, and e5, where he is going to place the bishop on c8? That is the big question here. So if you want to play bishop to f5, it is just controlled by the queen. As I was discussing, queen c2 is having one more idea that you'll know now. Queen c2 is just preventing the bishop f5 square. And what else is the square? So directly you can play bishop g4. Not simply to trade this knight and give up the double bishop advantage. He want to free this bishop so that he can play something like bishop h5 and bishop g6, trying to activate the bishop on the g6 diagonal. So now here comes the most prophylactic and very good waiting move, h3. Now even though if black plays e5, I don't have any problem, because bishop really don't have any good squares here. So such a great move is queen c2, vacating for the rook, threatening, preventing this, and waiting for a tempo to capture bishop into c4. So this move became very popular after Karpov played queen c2 for certain number of games. Okay, so from black, he should try to activate the bishop on c8. So the best way to is to play b6. Now he's having some good ideas like bishop b7, which is very strong. Maybe he want to play c5 and try to activate the bishop in this diagonal. Or he can even play something like bishop a6 and capture anything that comes in this path. Like bishop into c4 is also possible, because I just want to get rid of this bishop at any cost. Even this bishop, if I get to trade, that's a very fair deal. So bishop a6, either bishop into bc4, or even bishop b7 followed by c6, c5, and d into c4. So everything is very good. So b6. So again, now white played another good move to prevent both of the threats. So every white move is a big question, so I don't need to say anything. When black plays something, you just try to guess the white moves by just pausing the game for a few moments. Okay, so here white played e4, which is a very nice move. First thing about this e4 is it is opening the bishop diagonal on the c1. Second important thing is, right now bishop a6 is not a big threat, because I'm threatening e5 to capture one of these two pieces. So he should force a concession on trade on this pawn with either knight or with a pawn. So if he does any other threat like knight into or pawn into, then bishop a6 is completely useless, as he can't attack this c4 anymore. He can't bring any pressure if there is no pawn on d5. I can, even if I want, I can just defend by playing b3. So first thing is bishop a6 is completely ruled out. Second thing is I can't play bishop b7 immediately as I'm threatening to play e5. So Luther here thought of cap if he captures he might get some additional options of playing knight g5 and capturing with the other knight. So he just captured with the knight, leaving no other options for Karpov to take with the knight. So knight into knight, knight into knight, d into, and finally queen into. And queen is attacking the c6, so bishop b7 is forced to defend this one. And bishop f4. So this is very logical to exchange the opponent's strong bishop. So rook a d8, just making this rook come to the open file, semi-open file on the d file. Now it's a very very tough decision to take. What should we play from white? How you can improve the position? So the general ideas in this position, we cannot open anything, and at maybe one point, maybe black can try to play c5 if he supports this bishop on b7. So Karpov find a new option to get an advantage in this position. So he took bishop into d6, queen into d6. Now what is his idea behind capturing the bishop into d6? We cannot trade any pieces without a proper reason. So he just want to make sure that bishop on b7 is bad. So we can do that by placing this bishop to the f3 square. Somewhat I should make it forced to play, stop the c5, so that this bishop on b7 will be very bad. So this new idea you can understand only if you think for some time. Even for the most advanced level players, they need some time to analyze this position to see the idea of what Karpov is playing, trying to play here. So bishop into d6, queen into knight e5, vacating the f3 square. Knight into e5, d into e5, getting a tempo, also attacking the queen, opening up the d file. Queen c7. So you can see the obvious idea for black. c5. So no one needs to say anything about this one. So you need to stop c5. So bishop f3 is the only chance to stop that. And here black played a very very nice try. So leaving the open file and supporting the bishop is completely bad. So he want to open c5. Once if he achieves c5, there is nothing left in this position except a draw. So he played bishop to a8. It's a very nice move. Very nice try from black, so that now the rook is going to support the bishop and he is going to play c5, so that this bishop is going to be exchanged with the bishop on a8. Then this position with the major pieces, the position is roughly equal. There is no more advantage for white anymore. So so Karpov played another brilliant move. So he played this bishop, this rook is only the defense for the bishop. So he just exchanged the rooks. Rook into d8, rook into d8, and again this rook is only the defense. So the threat is to play c5. So rook d1. So if he plays c5, I'm going to take queen in, rook into rook, queen into, followed by queen into a8, and white will be a piece up. So rook into rook is forced, bishop into queen d8 is a very logical move, supporting the bishop, also attacking the bishop, taking the control of the open file, and also threatening to play c5 because the bishop is right now supported, which can create some pressure on the queen. So the normal move is to move the bishop and stop the c5. So bishop to f3, back again. After bishop f3, queen d2. So now we feel like black is very good even though he's having a bad bishop, at one point everyone thought like, yeah, black is doing good. He's having only one weakness, but his queen is having a very good open file. But Karpov played with his cool temper, with his cool nature. He played a very nice move, b3. And queen into a2. Okay, so now I would like you to pause this position and find a brilliant move for white. Okay, so most of us will get a very nice doubt. Yes, why not queen d4? Yeah, this is winning because there is no other way. Queen d8 checkmate and also loses the bishop on a8, or even something like queen d3 also does the same thing. But there is a stunning move that you might miss for black. That is queen a3. And if you give queen d8 check, queen is going to come and defend the checkmate and also supports the bishop. So Karpov saw this excellent defensive move, queen a3. So he played b4. This b4 is another brilliant move. You can say like, because right now he cannot capture this one. And if he plays one more delay, something like a5 or something like that, I can just play queen to d4 and I can win the bishop, at least a bishop. If you play g6 to prevent the mate, queen d8, king g7, and queen into a8 wins the bishop. So he need to stop. So he just gave one check, queen a1, king h2, and queen a6 is also the only move going back to the c8 square. Queen d4 threatening queen d8. Queen c8 is the only move. Now he is threatening the c5 again. So now comes another brilliant move, c5, blocking the c5s for black. And now you can see there is a permanent weakness of bishop on a8. So this game shows that even a slightest mistake like not developing a piece can cause you a very big problem in the later stages of the game. So after c5, b into c5, and when I keep this position, most of us will say, yeah, b into c5. But simply, why we need to give any counter chances like an outside passed pawn? Quick queen into d5, queen into c5, sorry. Now queen into c5 is immediately threatening something like b5. Right now this queen is under pin, so b5 is a very dangerous threat, threatening to take this one push. And I think you know this plan of making the queen on to c8. So queen c5 is also attacking the a7 pawn. So a6 is the only try to stop b5, and queen e7. Now, if you observe, black is a pawn up, but unfortunately, his pieces are not so great, and king position is not so good. Here, he tried something. He want to play something king outside to exchange the queens. At least he will be a pawn up, and maybe he might try for a defensive play. But he played g6. I seriously doubt about this move because this is a move where now white got a very good chance of winning, trying to play some counter attack on the king side. So g6, but there is no other move. If you see, if you play even h6 also, yeah, I can just control that h7 square with my bishop, so king cannot escape and you can't exchange the queens, and you can't weaken the pawn structure further just to make the king safe. That will be an even big mistake. So g6, I think it should be a logical move. So after g6, now we can't see any improvement from white. So Karpov here, after having a long thought, he find another brilliant move, trying to make this pawn structure bad. He pushed h4. Maybe he can play h5 and h6, creating the weakness on the king. Or he can try something like weakening the pawn structure. And yeah, so h5 is like preventing everything. Yeah, I'm going to stop. Now what you're going to do? So this is a very nice idea. So even now you can find one of these ideas in a needle shot game. The idea which I'm going to say now. Okay, so white is completely down, like his both the pieces are in the best square. He can't do anything to the king, so he brought the king to g3. This is a very nice, just he want to move the king in this dark squares, and maybe he can threaten this one. And once if the king reaches to the f6, I think that position should be winning for white, even though if he exchanges the queen by chance, if the king is on f6 and all the pawns are in the light color, this bishop is going to be having a very good future. Like black don't have any other move except to play only these two. He can't even change the diagonal to the c8, as bishop into c6 completely trapped with the bishop on the c8 square. So even though queens are exchanged, if king can reach to the f6 square, black should be winning, white should be winning the game. So king g3 is a very nice idea. Qb7 exchanging the queens, so white don't want to lose any tempo, so he just exchanged queen into b7, bishop into b7, king f4, king f8. So this is a normal end game. King g5, king e7, bishop e4. So white found this winning plan of so I just want to give you a quiz. I don't want to say this winning move. So just for those who are very interested in end game, just try to find how white can win from this position. Okay, so after bishop e4, black really don't have anything to improve. So he played bishop a8 and f3. So this is the most important move to win the game. So f3, the idea is to play g4. Even though if black captures, I take with the pawn, and now h5. I'm getting a free outside passed pawn on the h file. If king tries to defend that, my king is very fast to capture the f7 and g6 pawns, so that my e pawn will now start moving. Not only that, this f3 will have pressure to create an outside passed pawn and also to advance my king to the f6 square. Bishop b7, no other choice. g4, taking that is completely useless, so you don't have anything else. So bishop a8, g into h5, g into h5, f4. So Karpo is so cool that he don't want to even, if some break comes, he don't want to even lose the pawn on f3 also. So just play f4. I can keep the king here. Maybe I can move the bishop. And yeah, I can simply take with the king. So okay, so remember one thing, by playing c5 bishop into pawn takes, my bishop is so good to stop these two pawns. I can just clump to bishop e4, maybe b3, and if I lock the bishop here, it's over. So you can't advance anyway. Like for example, I'll say, so I'll just attack the pawn. Pawn pushes, and yeah, I'll just move this one to stop anything. Both the pawns will be stopped, so that's a very easy win. So bishop to b7, he played bishop b7, bishop to f3, just waited some more moves. Bishop here and king into h5. Here Luthier Jones felt like that this position is totally losing, and he resigned. So if he continued, this would be like maybe king f8, king here, king g7, then I'll play like h6, bishop here, h6, king here, bishop check, king here, and finally this will be a very easy win. Taking this, moving, and even I can trap the bishop also. Okay, so after seeing this game, we should have some doubts. What is the mistake that black white, sorry, black played in this game? He played almost all the logical moves, but why he lost the game? He lost because he didn't properly develop the bishop on c8, and that is how now the theory of this opening has been changed after queen c2, bishop d6, bishop e2. Now it is being changed to the move called d into c4. As many of your advanced players might know this, bishop into b5, bishop back somewhere trying. Now the bishop comes to the b7 square, a6 and c5. So this is the normal way, normal and logical way to open the bishop. In this position we can have many equal or slightly better positions for white. So this is not so losing as the game we have seen. Okay viewers, thank you for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to subscribe, and if you have any doubts in any opening, any middle game, end game or any position, please try to post that. I'll try to give a best solution for that. And if you are more interested in about the online coaching, just call my number or just give me mail me. I'll be definitely appreciate that. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. Hope you enjoy. We'll see you in the next video. Bye.